Luis Orozco para Flash Informativo. Buenas noches. I'm over here with my good friend Diana Briggs. Recibir resucitación cardiopulmonar, CPR in English. So tell me, you said that, sent me an article saying that the Hispanic population is a little behind on that aspect.
Well, we have found that in Hispanic neighborhoods, the bystander CPR rate is not as high as in other neighborhoods.
So we need to be educated. What do you do about doing that?
So we try at the American Heart Association to educate all populations and as many people as possible. We want to create more lifesavers. So throughout the community, we, at all our major events, we offer hands-only CPR training or bystander CPR. And we work with a lot of partners. We work with the City of Columbus Fire Department and some of our other local first responders to offer hands-only CPR training for free at events.
We're really prepping people to call 911 when something happened, and they will have a language that they will answer the phone on your language.
Yes, that is so critical in just really educating for people. You definitely want to call 911 first, right? Because you need help on the way. And the other thing is really educating people so that you feel comfortable and safe doing CPR. And really one thing to know is that if you ever are called on to do CPR, it'll most likely be in your home and most likely be a family member.
And also, it doesn't matter your immigration status when you call 911. Para Flash Informativo, Luis Orozco, gracias por tu sintonía. Hasta mañana.